It scared me. I didn't know what I was doing, but I listened to what I wrote, and it touched me so deep inside. I was calling everybody, man, listen to this, you know what I'm saying? It was like a kid in a new toy. And I was like, everybody, people thought I was crazy. Some people were like, what's wrong with this dude? Nothing, this is Jesus, man. He is talking to me. He has got my attention.
Hallelujah. Amen.
He taught me how to see with my eyes closed. And he taught me how to hear with my eyes and my ears closed. Because there's no voice like his. So now after that, now that I got your attention, God went through with me. All this was happening so fast. So after I started going to different poetry circles, I was meeting people. And I was on fire for the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I felt so blessed and highly favored that I had to share with everybody I can. And it's funny because when I went back that next Sunday, I wasn't that polished with it, but I did it. And you know, everybody, when they go to a place, they take a stage name. So I took the stage name John the Baptist, because when I was a little boy, I didn't even know how to spell John. I didn't know who John the Baptist was, but you know what? I had a grandfather named Levi. Every time he would call my name, he would say, John the Baptist. Just like that. John, bro, just throw John the Baptist, you know? Yeah. So when I went back this Sunday, I took that stage name, John the Baptist. Because I'm just trying to present the way for one to come. And warn as many people as I can, try to take as many people out this fire, and I try to keep them jokers from pulling me back. I'm going to do this. The second poem I wrote was called Wake Up America. Because it was fun and games when I was making the poem, I was just trying to tell you Jesus loved me.
Thank you.
But then Jesus wanted me to tell people something else. He said, wake them up. They sleep. They sleeping. What do you mean, Lord? They sleeping. He said, I'm sleeping in the daytime. I give you 168 hours in a week. You just can't give me two more Sundays. You think I'm satisfied? You shouldn't be satisfied. I tell people, that voice from within, we all know it. We done heard it. that voice say something to me, it sounds like nobody else. And after I got good with that poem, so I said, I'm gonna write another poem. This poem was written in 2006. Y'all think I look crazy now. I cut up my clothes, I put Jesus on everything. You know what, no matter where I'm at, because I'm always in church, I don't wait till no different day, I don't wait till Sunday. 24/7, 365. Okay, but tell them this. I say, this is the condition of the world, but especially America, right before Jesus get ready to come back. Revelation 3:17 said, thou seest I'm rich and increased with good, and have need of nothing. But knowest not that thou art rich and miserable, poor, blind, and naked, America. He said, to whom much is given, much is required. And America, I blessed you because you were the apple of my eye. But I do find you guilty of taking me for granted. And I ain't just kind of like that thorn in my side. He said, America, 9/11 was a wake-up call. I let it happen to get your attention. Because I need a few good men who are willing to stand up tall. Because Satan's people blow up plane, trains, and automobiles for his cause. He said, right now, America has a war on terror. People around the world are scared. North Korea, China, Iran, getting their bombs ready each day, getting ready to show America does. America, stay strong in Iraq, please, because I need you in Israel to stand against to bring Iran and Islam to bow down before me. He said, if the tsunami Katrina wasn't enough to get your attention and bring you to your knees, then maybe you should have. When you dial that 1-800 number sooner than in India, say, may I help you, please? That's why you were sleeping and playing politics in America. Sam Walton, Bill Clinton, both the Bushes, and now Obama. Send all your jobs overseas because they are Illuminati, just like Jay-Z. Wow. When I first wrote this poem, I went to L.A. And when I was in L.A., Emmitt Smith was a good friend of mine in Dallas. He was on Dancing with the Stars. So God sent me to LA and I performed with Theo, Malcolm Jamal Warner at this place in California called the Yankees. And while I was there, I got a chance to meet Martin Luther King Jr.'s daughter. And when I saw her, I said, I didn't want to disturb her, but I said, I wrote a poem called Wake Up America. And in that poem, I said, this is about your dad. She said, let me hear it. I said, my servant, Martin Luther King Jr., was sent to America for a very short time. But I wonder how he feels now that knowing not to fight so hard to get the shackles off our feet, that we would stop loving each other with equal rights and materialism. We don't let the devil put the shackles on our minds. Wow. Martin always said, America, together we stand, divided we fall. If you don't stand for something, you will fall for any man-made king. Because he fought for so much more that if he saw the way we treat each other today, he'd be so displeased and ask America, is this what I die for? Wow. All right. And when I said that to her, she pulled out a piece of paper and a pen and she gave me an email address and she said, email me the rest of that poem. I said, okay.
He said, my servant, Martin Luther King Jr., was sent to America for a very short time. But I wonder how he feels now that we don't have to fight so hard to get the shackles off our feet, that we would stop loving each other with equal rights and materialism. We don't let the devil put the shackles on our mind. Wow. Martin always said, America, together we stand, divided we fall. If you don't stand for something, you will fall for any man-made king. Because he fought for so much more than if he saw the way we treat each other today, he'd be so displeased to ask America, is this what I died for? He said, America, Malcolm X was a good man, and everyone knew him well. That brother didn't accept Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior before he took his last breath. That's just another brother like Tupac, Biggie, and Michael Jackson with a good cause. That's some they way ahead. Malcolm was a man who coined a phrase by any means necessary. But when he came back to America, the knowledge couldn't use anymore. They killed him and gave him back us prepared. I remember this is 2006. He said, America, wake up, it's 2006. The ACLU is dividing us and taking me away from the kids. Open your eyes and losing to you. Generation growing up not knowing the truth, because in school they teach them to unleash lies. You teach a kid, you come from an animal, then you get some pride, you go up and act like one. He said, because in school they teach evolution lies, but they won't teach creation and truth. There's so much deception going on, how the hell do you expect what the truth is? Drugs, sex, and rock and roll, this is a crowd of people. This thing called the BIBLE, basic instruction before leaving Earth, to if there is no equal. He said, America, wake up. It's 2006. He said, if you don't learn from your past 1929, the Great Depression, you are doomed to repeat 2009, the next Great Depression. He said, America, you're still a great nation. But if you blacks and whites, Republicans, and Democrats are going to start fighting each other, the devil will have you all back on the plantation. Why? Because the enemy is trying to destroy you, and he's doing it from within. Every white man ain't my enemy, every black man ain't my friend. He's got you fighting the world's problem, America, when the real problem is your sin. Because back in the day when it was black versus white, we all stuck together. But now that we're all mixing and dividing, why are we still fighting each other? He says, too late to close your borders. Now the enemy's already here. He said, your jungle's over for years. Why Clinton's an officer, Democrat. Learn how to fly an airplane, didn't know how to take everything. Because they love that devil so much, they're going to fly them through the two buildings in New York City and Washington, D.C. Money, power, respect. He says, too late to close your borders now, man. You ain't even trying no more. The enemy's already here. But right before the balls go flying, let's pray we all disappear. Now's the time to pray to go. We got the way John the Baptist said, Jesus Christ is our only hope. Wake up, America. Thank God.
On the stage. We appreciate John for all of his insight and zeal.